बरोबर रात में थी।
ओम ईश्वर गुरु रात में
मूर्ति
थी।
भेद विभागिने,
मूर्ति
विभागिने
व्योम
व्योमवत्यक्तदेहाय
दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः।
दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः।
सदाशिवसमारम्भम्।
सदाशिवसमारम्भम्
शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम्।
शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम्
अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम्।
अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम्
वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
ॐ सहना भवतु।
ॐ सहना भवतु।
सहनौ भुनक्तु।
सहनौ भुनक्तु।
सह वीर्यं करवावहै। तेजस्विधावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषा वहै।
तेजस्विधावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषा वहै।
ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम्। ॐ
पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम्।
व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणां मध्ये महाभारतम्।
व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्।
अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम्। अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवत्वेषिणीम्।
अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवत्
रुद्रमरुतस्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः।
यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्र रुद्रमरुतस्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः।
वेदैः सागपद क्रमोपनिषदैर्गायन्ति यं सामुगाः।
वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैर्गायन्ति यं सामुगाः।
ध्यानावस्थिततद्वतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यै योगिनः।
ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति योगिनः।
यस्यान्तन्न विदुः सुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः।
यस् नमः।
स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 31। ये मे मतमिदं नित्यम्।
अनुतिष्ठन्ति मानवाः।
श्रद्धावन्तो न सूयन्ते सूयन्तः।
श्रद्धावन्तो न सूयन्तः।
उच्यन्ते तेऽपि कर्मभिः। नानुतिष्ठन्ति मे मतम्। सर्वज्ञानविमूढांस्तान्। विद्धि नष्टान् चेतसः। सदृशं चेष्टते स्वस्याः। प्रकृते ज्ञानवानपि। प्रकृते यान्ति भूतानि। निग्रह किं करिष्यति। Gita's chapter 3rd, the verse 31 and 32, it says Bhagavan has summarized Karma Yoga, and in 31st verse, Bhagavan has said, one who doesn't follow this my contention, my conviction about this theory. Matam means Karma Yoga, ye me matam, a people, ye manavaha, a people, idam. Mama matam means my karma yoga's explanation. Nityam nanutishchanti. Nityam anutishchanti. One who follows constantly. And the qualification of such people, Bhagavan has said two adjectives. Shraddhavantaha. They have 100% trust. What I have said is called Shraddhavantaha. Anasuyantaha. They don't have any type of jealousy. Such people, time will come, they api, those people also gradually, karma bhihi muchyante, gradually they will release from the bondage of karma. Not immediately, but one by one, chitta shuddhi, then focus of mind, then shravan manan niti dhyasan, and lastly, karma bhihi muchyante. But one who follows karma yoga, and another verse is, one who they don't follow. Yete etat abhyasuyantaha me matam na anutishchanti. Those people abhyasuyantaha. Here anasuyantaha, here abhyasuyantaha. They are always finding a fault in others' behavior, in others' whatever. It's called abhyasuyantaha, jealous. And me matam na anutishchanti. If one has a personality to finding a fault, such people always find a fault even in Bhagavan's teaching, even in Gita's teaching, even in Upanishad also. It's called abhyasuyantaha. Such people are sarvagnan, vimudaha, vimudam, sarvagnana vimudaha. The meaning of sarvagnana means in Veda, there are two portions. One is Purva Bhaga, another is called Uttara Bhaga. Purva Bhaga is Karma Kanda, how to perform karma. And Uttara Bhaga is Upanishad, Vedanta. If they have Abhyasu Yantaha, they are always finding a fault. They don't have Shraddha in Vedas, so they never follow the first part of Veda and they never follow even second part of Veda. So they will be lose both. Even what are giving the message on first portion of Veda, they never follow. At the same time, they never accept Vedanta. So Sarvagnana means first part is called Aparavidya that I have told. And second part is called Paravidya. So from Apara and Para, both they are totally deluded. It's called Achetasaha. In spite of they have buddhi, but they don't have proper discrimination power. It's called Achetasaha. They consider Nashtan Viddhi. Bhagwan says, as good as they are Nashtaha, they are destroyed. Even though they have got this human being life, still they cannot make out. That's why Bhagwan says, they as though they are destroyed. Nashtan Viddhi. And why they cannot follow Karma Yoga and why they cannot follow the Bhagwan's teaching, that's why Bhagwan says, Bhagwan has picked up one point and he says, Gnanavan api prakrute hai svasyaha prakrute hai sadrusam cheshtate. Even Gnanavan api, a person who has knowledge, if such person also, svasyaha prakrute hai, according to one's own nature, cheshtate, they always act according to their own nature. So whatever their mind set up, same way they always be, their behavior will come. And Bhagwan says, Bhutani Prakriti Vyanti, all beings always follow their own nature. Nature means Svabhava. They all will follow their own nature. Even I used to say this carnivores. Carnivorous people, this animal, they kill all animals. They're prakriti. If we give a grass to lion or tiger, they never eat because their prakriti is to eat meat. Same way, cow never eats any non-veg. You always eat grass. Prakriti. It's her own prakriti. Same way, all people, all birds, animals, they have their own swabhava, their own mind setup. That's why Bhagwan says, Nigraha kim karishyasi. How can people can control their own prakriti? It is very difficult to control one's own nature. We can try to control others, we cannot control others, our own self. And why we cannot control our, for this Bhagwan has said this verse, 34th verse, I think we have said, Indriyasya Indriyasyarthe Ragadvesho Vyavasthito Tayor Navashamagachet Tohyasya Paripantino. We are seeing this verse. Now we will see. Prakrutim Cheshtasya Nigrahakim Karishyati. Indriyasya, indriyarthe. Indriyasya, indriyasya. For each and every sense organs, they have arthe, their own sense object. Here the means artha means they have their own sense object. And for all sense object, they have ragat vesho. They have their own likes and dislikes. They have their attachment and aversion. And always, arthe, I always say vishayaha, means sense object. Sense object are not only outside, means only thing. But I always say vishayaha may come, even human being also is an object. because it's considered as a sense object. If I like my mother, so it becomes a liking of my object. That's why even all human beings. So here, sense vishayaha means sense object, all people will come. That's why we have more likes and dislikes towards people. Then we have sense object, maybe different type of things. Things I don't like to write. Things vyavasthito. Very properly we have, I like this, I don't like this. Vyavasthito. And Bhagavan says, tayoho. Tayoho means both of them, 6/2. Both of them, and which 6/2? Raga dvesho. You should not conduct under the spell of raga dvesho. Tayoho vasham na agachet. You should not come under the spell of this raga dvesha. And why? That's why Bhagavan says, tohi asya paripanthino. The meaning of paripanthino means robbers, thieves. We always steal things from another person. Paripanthino. Especially when nowadays there is no paripanthino, but while we are traveling from one village to another village, no vehicle. Going by our legs or whatever. Small, you know, bull cart. At that time, there are many robbers. They can loot away. It's called paripanthino. So, raga dvesho robs away. Both are, they rob our intellect, our mind. They are rob away. That's why Bhagavan says, tayoho navasham agacche. Whatever we like, our mind, they won't allow to do. If we want, we don't like, we do. Now we will see anvayaha indriyasya indriyasya means both indriya, indriyasya indriyasya, for each and every indriya is called indriyasya indriyasya. Arthe means sense object. With reference to sense object, each and every indriya have raga dvesho. They have their own likes and dislikes. Vyavasthito means very professionally, we don't know, still we have properly. We like, we always divided two things. If we like, we keep with us. If we don't like, we always keep away from us. Vyavasthito. Bhagavan says, tayoho vasham na agache. We should not come under. Vasham means spell. Na agache. We should not come under the spell of it. And why? Tau means again both of them. Which are both of them? Raga dvesha. Both raga and dvesha. Asya means asya person. Karma yogi. Who is committed to karma yoga? For such person, both are considered as a paripanthino. They are the robbers. They are thieves. If anybody knows Rudra, Rudram. So in Rudra, I think third anuvaka, namas sahamanasya, this sahamanas, it starts. Each and different type of thieves, Bhagavan has elaborated. All thieves, Bhagavan says, are me. Namas sahamanasya nivyadina avyadina patahi namo namo. So same way, this paripanthino also is one type of robber. We always looted by person is traveling. Pantha means a road. Paripanthino. They always rob one who are traveling. Paripanthino. And who are these? So I have written indriyasya indriyasya means with reference to object of each and every sense organs. So we have five. So I have taken one. I have taken one is chakshu. Chakshu is in their sense object, whatever. Colors and forms, either we have raga or we may have dvesha. Whatever we like, we always keep with us, and whatever we don't like, we always ours and we keep ours. Not one thing. behave same way. Ear, same way behave. Thok, the skin, granaha, our nose, rasanaha, tongue. In Kathopanishad, it says, yes, last time also I have explained, they say in chariot, if there are five horses, rein of five horses in one who is driving the chariot, if five horses are not controlled of a driver, then what will happen to that chariot? Each and every horses will go their own field. Same way, we have five sense organs are considered as a horses. Whole world is a sense object. And each and every, these five sense organs, like horses, they will run towards their sense object. Then how can we can keep our mind cool, balance? That's why Bhagavan says, paripantino. That's why they are taken away our mind. And here, I have written one, this is Bhashyam of Shankaracharya. He says, what will happen while we see any object? So he says, purushasya prakritihi, the nature of person, what will happen to person? That prakritihi always, raga dvesha purahasara, is always preceded by our like and dislike. Purahasara means preceded by our raga and dvesha, means our own nature. Our prakriti always preceded by our likes and dislikes. And then, purusham pravartayati. Then, each and every person act, follow whatever our likes and dislikes. And when we follow our raga and dvesha, then what will happen? Swadharma parityaga. We will give up our own duty. Swadharma. We will give up. And what will happen? Paradharma anushthana. And we will take away others' duty. Bhavati, when our mind is not our control, when it is controlled by raga dvesha, but if punaha raga dvesho tat pratipakshena niyamati, if person has some willpower, pratipakshena means if we have something like, then we find a fault. If we like rasgulla, if we like any sweet, no, we have like, then pratipaksh means we can see the opposite part. If we keep on eat this sweets, then maybe diabetes. The sweets can give diabetes. If we think, it's called pratipaksha bhavana, which is coming, last time I have said, it comes in Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Pratipaksha. What we see, we have to see opposite. Same way, if we hate someone, so each and every people, some, you know, some quality, if we try to find out, it's called pratipaksha. This process, niyamati, if we control our raga dvesha, then what will happen? Tada, then saha purushaha shastra drashtihi bhavati. Then that person will follow what the vision of shastra. Shastra drashti, shastra means scripture, drashti means vision. Purushaha bhavati, then purusha, a person will follow the vision of shastra and na prakriti vashaha. He is or she is not under the spell of prakriti. Raga dvesha. That's why Shankaracharya ji says, tasmat, for that reason, tayoho means raga dvesha yoho, both of them, vasham na agachhe. You should not under the spell. And somebody says, why? So it says, Shankaracharya ji said, yataha means because of that, tau means raga dvesho, asya purushasya paripantino. He is the robbers of this person. And paripantino means, Shankaracharya has written, shreya margasya vignakartaru. They are considered as the obstacles of our good path. Shreya means we can take a spiritual path. Even we can take, even dharmic way, if we are living a life, they consider as an obstacle. Even prayer marg also, never give peace if we never follow dharma. tuskaro eva. Esto de arethius robbers iti artha. The meaning is we should not follow our raga dvesha, but raga dvesha should control in under our control. In what will happen, that I have written, but I have written one thing more. What will happen if we keep on following our nature? It says our swabhava means our prakriti. According to our swabhava, we start thinking. Whatever we think, we put in our words. Whatever we say, it becomes in our action. Whatever is action, we keep on doing, then it becomes our hobby. And what is our hobby, then it becomes our nature. So always what we think, that if we say, that will we do, it becomes a hobby, and this hobby is our destiny. It becomes our destiny, our nature, prakriti. So we may have some question, if prakriti is not in our control, then what is the meaning of free will? If both raga dvesha consider as a robbers, they take away our intellect, our proper thinking. So free will, is there any role of free will or not? So it says, even Pujya Swamiji used to say, thought process, if one thought pops up in our mind, it is not in our control. But if starts channelized, dhyayato vishayan pumsaha, then only it disturbs. So when we know this such nuisance, which is not proper thought, just pops up in our mind, then free will can control second thought. You should say no to our mind. You should not think like this. So it's nipped off from second thought. We can use our free will, even words also. Even still, that thought process keep on going in our mind, but it should not come out from our mouth. So still, we can have free will. We can use our free will, and it should not come from our mouth through words. And we can, free will can control our actions also. Properly thinking, free will, through free will, we can control our actions. If thought has come, this person is not good, you give one bad word to this person, but our mind, we can say, it is not proper. You should not say like, speak like this, then we are using our free will. So we can, even prakriti is very difficult to change, but Bhagavan has given a gift of free will, and because of free will, we can change our nature. Prakriti kim nigraha karishyasi, but still we have right, we can keep control of our mind. So free will can control even thought process, free will can control words and actions. And there is a one also I have written, I don't know that, when flame is feeble, no? Then wind becomes enemy and puts up the flame. But if fire is used, then wind doesn't have capacity to put off fire, then what wind will do, both will become friends. They, now I become friends. Same way, if thought is feeble, if thought is not healthy, then intellect can handle. Our buddhi can say, this thought is not proper. Because it's only one thought. But if we nourish our thought process, then what will intellect will do? Then it starts justifying. I'm thinking like this because such has done. So always, whenever intellect is free will, we should not nourish the improper thought process in our mind. this is one word is coming, if you remember, in the 13th chapter, Amanitvam Adambitvam Ahimsa Shanti, and last one is Arjavam. The meaning of Arjavam means what you think, so you speak. So what you speak, so you act. So there is an alignment of thinking, speaking, and doing. Same way, if we think proper, we speak proper, and we act proper, that there is a very beautiful verse is given in Subhashitani. So it is here, yatha chittam tatha vachaha, yatha vachaha tatha kriyaha. Yatha chittam, just as what we think, tatha vachaha, means so we speak. Yatha vachaha, what we speak, tatha kriya, same we act. Then it says, chittam means thought process, vachi means our words, kriyayam in our action, ekarupata, if oneness, it's called sadhunam. Sadhu, a good people, always have an alignment, ekarupata of think, words, and action. If we have our proper thinking process, we have free will, then we can just cut off the improper thought and we can do a good thing. So whenever we come, Prakrutim Yanti Bhutani Nigrahakim Karishyasi, other than human being, they cannot Nigrahakim Karishyati, but we all people can do, we can control our mind, we can control our likes and dislikes. So in, I think Pooja Swami, I don't know, but in some other, they have written, the meaning of Kim Karishyati is one type of exclamation. How can we cannot control our raga and dvesha? Being human being, we can control. How cannot? And last verse. People, if they follow whatever comes according to Prakruti, then it is very dangerous. That's Bhagavan says in last, this is 35th. This is the Karma Yoga's last verse. Shreyan Svadharmo Vigunaha Pardharmat Svanushthitat Svadharme Nidanam Shreyaha Pardharmo Bhayavaha. Paradharmat su anushthitat, having followed another's duty, svadharmaha, our own duty, vigunaha api, it's not up to mark, you know, it is not perfect, but still shreyan, it is better. And Bhagavan says, it's well, very well famous, often quoted is, svadharme nidanam shreya. It is better to die in our one's duty performing paradharmaha bhayavaha. To follow another's duty is fraught with fear. It is always with fear. And why Bhagavan has said, so first I have done the anvaya. Anvaya is su anushthitat. Yes, swanushthitat means su means properly. Anushthitat means having followed paradharma. This is called comparative decree. This fifth case, but it is not apadane, but it is a comparative. Compared to properly performed another's duty, swadharmaha, our own swadharma is vigunaha api. It is not perfect, still shreyan, it is more better. And Bhagavan says, Svadharme Nidanam Shreya. Shreya means it is better having a death, performing one's own duty, Paradharmaha Bhayavaha. Always others, dharma of another's person is fraught with fear. But let's see what is dharma. So I have written, once I have seen, I think if you remember, but in second chapter. So what is dharma? Dharma is not only one. There are many meanings of dharma. One dharma is called universal dharma. It's called samanya dharma in Sanskritam. In Kathopanishad, atma considered as a dharma. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. At that time, meaning of dharma is punya papa. And here, swadharme nidanam shreyam. So here, the meaning of dharma is vishesha dharma, means our own duty, personal duty. So I have the samanya. Dharma is svatmani pratikulani anyesham na acharyate. It will come. That's why I want it. But in Atma Kathopanishad, it says, anuhu eshaha dharmaha. Here, anuhu eshaha dharma means Atma is very subtle. So here dharma is not punya papa, here dharma is not duty, but dharma is Atma. Again, sarvan dharman parityajya, it is punya papa, but swadharme nidhanam shreya paradharma bhayavaha. So what is the dharma is duties and responsibilities. Here the meaning, swadharma. And what are the duties? So according to our Hindu scriptures, it says varnashram dharma. You might have heard. And whenever I say varna, varna means Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, it is not jhatitaha, but guna karmataha. Always we have to remember, it will come in fourth chapter, it is very soon it will come. But varna is gunataha. Guna means rajo guna, sattva rajas tamas guna, and karmataha, according to karma. Having kept base, this varna, this gunataha karmataha, Bhagwan has given four varnas to our society. One is called Brahmin, Brahmanaha, another is called Vaishya, agriculture, all type of Shudraha, one who does seva, and Kshatriyaha. So what is the duty? Really speaking, Swadharma. What is the Swadharma of Brahmana? It says the Swadharma of Brahmana is Pathanam, Patanam. He has to study and he teach others. Patanam is teaching. Patanam is study. Yajanam, Yajanam. He has to do for him different type of yajna and Yajanam. He has to becomes a priest for others' yaga. So yajanam, danam. He can receive different type of danam. At the same time, pratigraha means he can also do dram. He or she can do also danam. It is not brahmana has always accept danam. Even brahmana can also donate. So pratigraha means brahmana can also donate. Vaishya, the meaning of vaishya, all are gunataha. Karmataha. Vaishya means krushi, go, vanijya. All type of what we call economy is always run by Vaishya. So who are interested in economy, arthashastra, are called Vaishya. Shudra means this is their own duty. This is Swadharma. Shudra means one who are dull, tamogun predominant, but they always, their duty is to serve. Even Shishya is serving teacher. So Shudra is not always lowly action, but Shudra is always help to keep everything clean. And last is Kshatriya, means administrative. Even all army consider as a Kshatriya. And what are their qualities? So they should have shaurya, means valor, they should have brilliance, druti, means they have resolving power, skill, yudde apalayam, they should not come back from battlefield, leadership, danam, they always, these all are qualities and duties of varna. However, if suppose even at that time also I have said our Dronacharya is a Brahmana. And what was his karma? He is in Kshatriya. So he is not following his own duty, Swadharma. Same way, according to Karana or Shudra, Adhirata, but by birth he is a Kshatriya. But he was living with Adhirat, means Shudra. Gandhiji, I always used to say, Gandhiji by birth, Vaishya. But his all qualities is like Brahmana, Sattvika. But he is always administrating power. He has given all freedom. So he's Kshatriya. So we are always mixture of three gunas according to way we are doing our own duty. Now Bhagavan says, so anishthita, so anushthita par dharmat. So if anushthitat means perform, but so means well performed. Par dharma, another dharma, and which dharma? What I have given, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. It is universal for whole world. It is not only for India. It is universal for whole world. So compared to well performed, par dharma, another dharma, and I have given another more example. Suppose a soldier of India, one is army man in our army, but he is a spy for another country. So he's doing paradharma anushti. He is a paradharma. He is whatever doing is not correct. As Bhagavan says, swadharmaha vigunaha api. Even one's own duty, that soldier doesn't like to fight, but swadharmaha vigunaha api. Even he doesn't like, he is not perfect. But shreyan, it is better. Swadharme nidhanam, if he dies in battlefield, so definitely he will get punya. But he will get caught by some army person as a spy. So what will happen to him? Same way, it can apply to anyone. That's why Bhagavan says, swadharmaha vigunaha api shreyan swadharme nidhanam. We should better to die one's own duty. If somebody asks, okay, what will happen if I won't perform my duty? I used to say, suppose one artist is there, one whose naturally inclination is in painting, two different type of sculpt. If such artist has asked you do, otherwise you go and join army, then what will happen to you? If he will join, if he doesn't have money, if he will join the army, then does he enjoy that job? So in previous time, in India, previous time what happened? Brahmana's son always Brahmin. They have to do Brahmin work. Same way, Vaishya's son has to perform economy. Kshudra's son or daughter, they have to do this. Vishesha dharma is parichaya, then Kshatriya's son becomes Kshatriya. Because it's our thinking, all are always become gunataha karmataha according to varna. But Shudra become Brahmana, Brahmana become Shudra, then what will it? That's why Bhagavan says it is very difficult for them. So therefore it is better to die, have a death in our performing one's all duty. This is what I have written. It's Pujya Swamiji's example. He says, suppose one goalkeeper of soccer, football match, what is his job? Always to protect their volley. It doesn't go inside that. But if he doesn't like to stand in one place, he said, I would like to run like other players, then it is paradharma. It is bhayavaha because another team will get goals. That's why swadharma, whether he likes, whether he don't, he doesn't like, but he has to follow the rules of goalkeeper. And I have written, swadharma always gives satisfaction. Whatever I have duty, I have done according to my capacity. So it always gives satisfaction, shanti. Our mind always have calmness, coolness. But while we are doing others' duty, always our mind becomes restless because we are not performing our duty, we are doing for others. So it never gives a peace of mind. Our mind always be restless. And even if we follow our swadharma, then no conflicts. And if we follow others, then what we don't like, really speaking, Baba Ramdev. Nowadays we say Baba Ramdev is a sannyasi. But he's a Vaishya. He's a good, you know, businessman. See, paradharma, really speaking, is considered a paradharma. So at the end, when he starts thinking, no? So whatever, what he is in my, I don't know, but if he starts thinking as a sannyasi, should I follow my sannyasi dharma or not? So he can't say yes, because sannyasi is always has to say, teaching everything, and he is totally opposite. So his mind should not be at peace, you know, if he thinks properly. And another I have told a story once, but there was a one businessman. He is a very big businessman. He has to fly early morning next day at 4 o'clock. He asked his watchman, you please wake me up at 2 o'clock so I can reach airport timely, on time. Then watchman say, okay. So at 2:30 or 2 o'clock, that his rings the bell, and that when businessman wakes up, and he just about to go for, you know, let me become ready. At that time, watchman has asked the businessman, this is my request. He says, yeah, what is your request? He says, today I saw one dream. In dream, I have seen in which flight you are flying, it will be crash. So it is better you should not fly in this flight. You just skip this flight. You can take another flight. He says, okay. And he says, whatever I have seen, it never goes wrong. You please follow. Then he says, okay. When what happened, what he has seen comes true. Flights crashed and he saved. That businessman has saved. So next day, again he calls watchman, and watchman was very happy. He says, today I will get reward from businessman because I have saved the life of that my boss. That boss says, welcome him. He gave a big envelope to him, and he says, from today, I am now, you are not no more watchman. You should not do this watchman. He says, why? Because I have saved your life. But he asked, what is the duty of watchman? He cannot suppose to sleep, no? And he has dreamed. Must he go ahead, want to sleep? So he says, Swadharma, if you sleep, so Swadharma, you have not followed your Swadharma. And today, you have told me, every day you must be sleeping only, no? That's why I am giving money, lots of money, but at the same time, I'm released from this duty. Because being a watchman, you should always awake. So, paradharma bhayavaha. So, what he has tried to do, good thing, but it's not good for him. That's why Bhagavan says, swadharma nidhanam shreya. We have to do our one's own duty. Whether everybody will, even we know, when we perform our duty, properly, we need not reward from others. We know what I have done is always perfect. Then we never wait for others' appreciation. This is the best thing of do one's own duty. If I do as a father, as a mother, even as a sannyasi, as a student, whatever, in whichever field, what we have done perfectly, so we never wait for others. Let somebody come and appreciate me. It's called no conflict. We always be happy. This is sounds very nice. You know, everything will good, good. You know, Arjuna said, I would like to do my once own duty, but I don't know what has happened to me. So now Arjuna is going to ask. And this question is almost same what Duryodhana said to Krishna. When Krishna says to Duryodhana, you should not fight Mahabharata war, you should not do any adharma. Then this is the verse from Mahabharata. Duryodhana says, Janami dharma nachame pravritti. He says, I know what is dharma, but nachame pravritti, I cannot follow it. In spite of knowing what is dharma, what is proper, na pravritti, I cannot follow dharma. Janami adharma. I know what is adharma, but nachame nivritti, I cannot retreat. I cannot come back from adharma. In spite of knowing what is dharma, what is adharma, still I cannot come back from adharma and I cannot follow dharma. And what he says, kenapi devan, there is somebody sitting, radhisthitena, somebody sitting in my heart, rudhi, in my heart, sthitena, somebody sitting, this is passing, kenapi devan, somebody is sitting in my heart, yata nayukta, what he impels me, tatha karomi, what he asks to me, you have to do this, and then I follow him. I don't know he's sitting inside me, and he asks, impel me to do, tatha karomi. Same thing, have it kept in this mind. Arjuna also asks same thing to Arjuna, I know everything, what is my swadharma, but still, in spite of knowing everything, I cannot able to do. So let's see, only verse. Arjuna uvacha athakena prayuktoyam papam charati purushah anichanna pivashneya baladiva niyojitah. Arjuna said, ayam purushah papam charati. Ayam means this, purushah means person. Papam charati means he acts wrongly. Papam charati. Kena prayukta, impelled by whom? Somebody is there, is impelled. Impelled by whom? Person papam charati, anichchanapi. Even that person doesn't like to do, anichchanapi. Anichchanapi one, but still, baladiva niyojita. Forcefully somebody is joining, niyojita. Same way, what? Who is that person? Who is sitting inside, who asks, forcefully to do papam, to commit a papam. But we will see tomorrow, not today. Any question regarding this? No question? Everybody knows?
Swaminiji, that verse about Samanya Dharma.
Yeah.
We saw one line.
Yeah, that I didn't saw. No? Wait a minute.
Oh, where is that from?
It is a universal. Svatmani pratikulani anyesham na acharet. The meaning that we don't like, we should not do to others. If somebody hurts me and I don't like, then I should not hurt. It's according to Guru Swami, it says the universal verb. We need not to teach us. If somebody tells a lie in front of me and I don't like, I should not tell a lie. This Swatmani means Swatmani in self, pratikulani, which we don't like, अन्येषां न आचरेत् वी शुड नॉट परफॉर्म फॉर अदर्स अन्येषां फॉर अदर्स न आचरेत् शुड नॉट परफॉर्म आचरेत् ईत शुड नॉट आचर
And Swamiji, I heard somewhere that something like Janmana Jayate Shudra, that everyone is born as a Shudra only.
Janmana, there is also, I don't know by heart, but it is a beautiful verse. Only one who knows Brahma, it's called Brahmana. Brahma, not Brahmana. One who knows Brahma, it's called Brahmana. All are by birth, and all are Shudra. So all are nobody is Brahmin by birth. If they even they are born in Brahman family, there are many Brahmanas here in Gujarat. Always they are eating tobaccos. They don't know how to properly words. Then how can we consider as a Brahmin?
We are born ignorant and then we have to raise.
Yeah. Shall we do Purnamada?
Yes.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat
Purnamudachyate
Purnasya
Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Namaha Hari Om